Welcome! When starting your Desmos art journey, you may want a different color than the standard 6 offered in the calculator. Here, we'll walk through different techniques to get the perfect color for your next piece. Now, we are going to demonstrate this in the Desmos 2D graphing calculator, but these same strategies work on both the geometry and 3D calculators as well. We're starting here with 4 circles, and this is going to be our workspace for creating and showing custom colors. Let's look first at the default options that are always available. In the expression list, anything that is appearing in our graph has a circular icon to the left of it, and by clicking and holding this icon, we can access the style menu. While some settings change based on the type of object, the color options will always be the same. In our tools, there is a starting palette of 6 default colors. Let's change our circles each to their own color: blue, red, green, and purple. Now you may notice that the color of our objects look a few shades lighter than the color icons looked. These objects all have their own opacity, represented by the fill setting, which is a scale from totally invisible at 0 to 1, which will be a solid color. We will set all of our fill values to 1 to visualize our colors clearly. Now we're ready to create our first custom color. Desmos has 2 different color functions: RGB, which stands for red, green, blue, and HSV, which stands for hue, saturation, value. Any new color that we want to make must start with a variable name. We will call our first color C1 and set that equal to an RGB value. Both of the color functions take 3 different numbers as inputs. For example, we can let C1 be equal to RGB of 100, 200, 200. That is, the color with a red value of 100, green value of 200, and blue value of 200. For a defined color, a little color swatch appears on the expression line. Now we will go up to our first circle expression, which represents the circle in the top left of our graph, and see how this same color swatch has been added to the list of available colors, which we will select. Now, if we don't know the exact color code we want, we can use sliders to experiment with different colors. Let's define a second color, C2, using the RGB function. But instead of 3 numbers, we will use the variables R, G, and B. Just like any variable in Desmos, we can now add sliders to adjust these values. Notice how the default intervals for each of these goes from 0 to 255, which is the standard interval for the RGB color scale. I can now adjust these sliders and see how the C2 color swatch changes. Once we find values we like this 220, 115, 150, we can go ahead and change the color of our second circle, located in the top right of our graph. For our third color, let's try using HSV. Very similar to the format of RGB, we will define C3 to be equal to HSV of 3 numbers. Let's say 85, 0.6, 0.8. That is, a hue of 85, a saturation of 0.6 or 60%, and a value of 0.8 or 80%. We will set the bottom left circle to this color. To visualize each of these components, let's define our final color, C4, with sliders for H, S, and V. Notice that the interval for H is 0 to 360, but both S and V are 0 to 1. Changing the hue is like cycling through the colors of the rainbow. Saturation is the intensity of that color, and value is the lightness or darkness. We will settle on an HSV of 200, 0.8, 0.65, and we'll change our last circle, located in the bottom right, to this final color. We can't wait to see the custom colors you use to bring your next creation to life.